Let's take a look at several security models. Many security models are based on the generic state machine. Once we consider the state machine, we'll look at the Bell-LaPadula model, the Clark-Wilson model, the BIBA model, the information flow model, and the non-interference model. Now, there's six models we'll take a look at. Each one teaches us a little bit more about how to implement good security practices. So we'll start with the state machine. The state machine model is built on a mathematical model of a state machine. In that context, a state machine shows the state of all objects at one particular point in time, and it shows the transitions from one state to another. In the context of a security model, the state machine specifies the state of a system of all subjects and objects at a particular point in time, and then maps the transition from one state to another in a controlled fashion. For example, we have a subject who is requesting access and an object which has not been accessed. The next state of the machine would be the state in which the subject has successfully accessed the object. Well, how do we get from requesting access to an object to actually accessing that object? Well, that's a transition from one secure state to another secure state. Since the state machine model maps that and very strictly defines how we get from one state to another, the transition can be controlled, and we can formally design the controls to move from one state to another. Since they all are always defined, the system is always in a secure state. It's either in one secure state, a source secure state, we are currently in a transition, or we are in a final secure state. Many of the following security models are built on the state machine concept, so it's important to understand the concept of what a state machine actually is.